Have you ever really listened to songs? You might notice many of them have weather references.
That's right. Right now, we are going to listen to some songs, and Alex is going to let us know if the weather lyrics are true or a myth. And thank you for sending in your song ideas to us as well.
Yes.
So we're going to use some this morning.
So up first, Smoky Mountain Rain by Ronnie Millsap.
Smoky Mountain Rain. Well, tell us about it.
Ronnie Millsap, one of his greatest hits right there. He's referring to the climate overall in East Tennessee, the Smoky Mountains, the Appalachian Mountains. It's really, I mean, it's a wet climate up there.
Yeah.
So
really,
when we think of a wet climate, you usually think maybe Seattle. Mm-hmm. You think maybe the Florida Peninsula. Mm-hmm. It's raining at 3 o'clock.
Yeah.
Thunderstorms every day. But the Smokies get about 58 to even 60 inches of rain a year. That's right. It's one of the rainiest places in the continental U.S. And it all has to do with terrain. So the terrain influences the big old Smoky Mountains. That enhances the condensation process where water falls from the sky. And oftentimes it's just a lot of rain that's moving across there, but it's a very wet climate. And you can see a picture of the Smokies right there.
Wow.
It's always kind of like a foggy, misty type of atmosphere.
Yeah.
I got to go about 2 years ago. Have y'all been to the Smokies?
I don't know that I've been to the, is Gatlinburg?
Around, yeah, that's it.
So I have been there.
Asheville, North Carolina, Knoxville, Tennessee.
Okay. Yes, so I've been to Asheville and have driven through like on the interstate.
Yeah.
And I've got a trip to Gatlinburg coming up in a few months.
So
go check it out soon. Okay, good to know.
Clingman's Dome up there produces about 80 inches of rain.
Okay.
That's one of the highest elevations.
Wow.
So pretty interesting, their weather pattern.
Hmm. Yeah, well, up next, this is a fun one. It's Raining Men by the Weather Girls.
Ooh.
Classic. Forecast just in time for Valentine's Day, right?
That's funny.
But this illustration is best done with one of our surface map products.
Okay.
I wanted to show y'all this. I'm going to go to the wall real quick and show y'all kind of how this works. So pressure and humidity, you just heard it in the first line of the Weather Girls classic 80s hit. They go hand in hand. So the closer you are to the big L here on our surface map, the lower the pressure gets. So the low pressure is indicated by the dark blues, and the higher pressure is indicated by the lighter blues. So watch as we go along here and this low progresses eastward to the CSRA. Watch what happens. So the lower the pressure, the more a southerly flow comes out into the southeastern United States. You get warm, humid air out ahead of these low pressure systems, and then behind them, you get cold, dry air. So when the weather girls say that the humidity's rising and the barometer's getting lower, well, the lower the pressure, the higher the humidity, because it stirs up more of a southerly flow. So that's kind of the science behind it, and you can watch it in real time as these things pass. It's pretty similar to what we're seeing today across the CSRA. Cold, dry air is coming in on the backside of this cold front, and it's giving us a lot lower humidity and a lot of sunshine because that dry air just dissolves all the cloud cover. So a pretty interesting explanation behind that. And the Weather Girls were actually spot on, as they usually are. Some good songs from them, as always.
Yeah.
Never think of that song the same.
Yeah.
I know, right?
Exactly.
You always got to think about the science behind these things. And I don't know. Y'all don't have brown eyes, do you?
Or do
you?
I do. I have brown eyes.
Wait, okay, well, this song's for you.
We all do.
Yeah, I'm like, what color are they going to be? No, I'm kidding.
A brown-eyed girl. She's a brown-eyed girl.
There
you go. This is the song by Van Morrison.
Yes.
Skipping and a jumping.
My bad. Hazel. All right, so we've got Skipping and a Jumping in the Misty Morning Fog, and this is after Days When the Rains Came. So for Van Morrison, he was talking about what we call advection fog. Okay. And I'm going to get into that here on the weather wall as well. Okay. Let's go ahead and show you kind of what's up with that. It's the reason we've seen so much fog this week. It's called it. We have different types. One of them is radiation fog. Happens on and out with clear skies and calm winds. That won't be the case tonight, by the way. But this is what we've been talking about over the past few days. We've seen patchy, dense fog. The reason for that is we've had highs in the 50s and lows in the 30s. So the ground has been nice and cool, right? Well, that's changed over the past few days. Low temperatures were right at 60 just a few days ago. That's warm, moist air moving over the cool ground surface temperatures. What that does is it causes some of that air to condense, and it gives way to some cloud cover. Well, we've had plenty of that over the past week, right? That cloud cover, it traps in a lot of the moisture after Sunday and Monday's rain, if you can recall that. So when we have low-level cloud cover, it traps in all the warm, moist air at the surface. It all condenses, and it gives way to some of that patchy to dense fog that you've seen over the past few days. Now, fortunately, dry conditions, no fog to go for the rest of this weekend, but that's kind of the explanation behind that. It just gets trapped in these cold air wedge conditions that we've seen over the past few days.
Wow, that's been, we've given a lot of great information this morning for sure.
Well, you know, you can always mm-hmm. find weather and music. It's not hard to find. And Jimmy Buffett also does Brown Eyed Girl. I'll give you guys a Jimmy Buffett song next week.
Okay, nice. Sounds good. And if you want have a song that you want us to maybe feature, send it to Alex on his Facebook page. But for now, we'll be right back.